Our next piece is by Indian-American composer Reena, Esmail, her string quartet Ragamala. Reena writes about the piece. During the year I spent in India, I began to notice a beautiful thing that would happen at concerts. When the artist would announce the rag to be sung or played that evening, immediately and almost subconsciously, many of the members in the audience would begin humming the characteristic phrases of that rag quietly to themselves, intoning with the drone that was already sounding on stage. It had a magical feeling, as if that rag was present in the air, and tiny wisps of it were already starting to precipitate into the audible world in anticipation of the performance. It felt like a connection between the audience and the performer, as they prepared themselves to enjoy what was to come. Each movement of this quartet opens in exactly the same way, and it is inspired by those quiet intonations. After the opening phrases, each movement diverges into its own distinct character. The first movement is a fantasy, inspired by the beautiful rag Bihag, which layers phrases over one another to create large shapes separated by the silence of pure drones. The second movement is a vivacious and rhythmic setting of a Makan's tan, which to the Western ear always seems to be pulling to a dominant rather than a tonic. The third movement is in the contemplative basant, a rag that signifies the season of spring in Hindustani music. And the fourth movement is in the complex and multifaceted jog, a single rag which seems to contain Western notions of both major and minor within it. In Hindustani music, the elaboration of single rag can often take an hour. I didn't mean for this piece to exhaust those rags, but rather provide little snapshots of particular features and characters of each rag that I find beautiful and special about each one. We've loved working on this piece. Thank you for writing it, Reena, and we hope you all enjoy it tonight.
Thank you. Thank you. For our final piece on the program, we will be playing Beethoven's Opus 18 No. 2 String Quartet in G Major, written between 1798 and 1800 and published a year later. The structure and phrasings were more in the style of his teacher at the time, Franz Joseph Haydn. Unlike his stormy Opus 18 No. 4, his New Age Opus 18 No. 6, and more motivic Opus 18 No. 1, his Opus 18 No. 2 quartet is much more playful and satisfyingly content to be played in a major key for most of the time. Unofficially nicknamed the Compliments Quartet, for the opening passages full of grace and poise, I urge you all to listen to the in-between, the time in between the notes, and the simplistic, whimsical, joyful fun as we all frolic throughout the piece. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.